Continuation of the former video. The Intertropical Convergence Zone, or ITCZ, appears as a band of clouds that encircles the globe near the equator. Since the NASA research videos presented here do not illustrate clouds, but carbon dioxide instead, this band of clouds is invisible, but we can observe carbon dioxide accumulations being built up in the course of 1 year. And as you see in the NASA video, the buildup of carbon dioxide accumulation exclusively takes place in the Northern Hemisphere, and not at all in the Southern Hemisphere, more correctly south of the ITCZ band. As a note, there certainly are emissions going on in the Southern Hemisphere, but these emissions are not able to build up, obviously because absorption is more important than emission. Throughout this video and series, we will illustrate that the Amazon rainforest, along with the rainforest of the Democratic Republic of Congo and the rainforest of Southeast Asia, are central to the astonishing fact that accumulation does not occur in the Southern Hemisphere, and the potential of accumulation not being able to occur in the Southern Hemisphere. Quite quick, and in a matter of a few months of accumulation, the build-up in the Northern Hemisphere starts to press against the invisible ITCZ band, which now becomes visible, because of the Northern Hemisphere carbon dioxide accumulating above it. Possibly this is the first time your attention is drawn to this otherwise invisible and for climate important barrier, and the pressure built up from the carbon dioxide accumulation of the Northern Hemisphere. Air with more carbon dioxide is heavier and exerts more pressure than air with less carbon dioxide, hence we call the observable carbon dioxide accumulation also a buildup of pressure. The invisible ITCZ band is a relative barrier that partly stops air and carbon dioxide from trespassing, and consequently also a partial barrier for carbon dioxide to cross over to the Southern Hemisphere, Hadley Cell and Hemisphere south of this band. Nevertheless, as explained, there is pressure on this band from the north, and since the barrier is not absolute, carbon dioxide percolates continuously through it, and even literally overflows the barrier by means of jet streams and eventually breaks open the barrier, this in cases that too much pressure has built up in the Northern Hemisphere. In this case, the band becomes unstable, and a kind of turbulence with some kind of limited vortexes occurs. When pressure on both sides has once again become more equal, the turbulence stops, and the natural barrier is kind of naturally restored, at least until the next significant pressure difference builds up and disturbs the barrier once again. While there is pressure from the northern atmosphere along all of the band around the globe, in an first phase, there is increased downward carbon dioxide pressure to the northeast of Africa, but whatever carbon dioxide breaks through under this pressure will move in the direction of the Amazon forest, this so because of the westward movement of the passat winds above and below the ITCZ band or barrier. Asia and Europe together with the Middle East form a massive carbon dioxide emitting block without tropical forests, and exerts pressure to the northeast of Africa. It is not at all impossible that carbon dioxide attraction is exerted by the Amazon forest itself, or at least that is what it looks like. There can be several reasons for such an attraction by the Amazon forest. First of all, the Amazon forest and the fact that the whole of South America presents no accumulation from itself, in combination with intensive absorption by forest and vegetation covering the whole of South and Central America, creates a kind of osmotic pressure vacuum. This osmotic pressure vacuum, in combination with the explained atmospheric pressure vacuum that amongst others is caused by the lower carbon dioxide content of the air, can be part of the reason for the apparent attraction by the Amazon forest. Further, there also are the asymmetrical cooling effects of Amazonian protected areas across spatio-temporal scales. To simplify the Amazon forest effects, we prefer to refer to the Amazon forest's biotic pump effect, about which you can find plenty yourself on the internet. This video is part of a series and to be continued.